I'm sure you're wondering why I'm lying on the ground instead of standing up and talking to you. That's because I'm here to talk about social distancing. Make that physical distancing. That's the term that public health officials want us to use during the pandemic. The idea isn't that you have to cut off all social contact when you go outside to prevent transmission. You can still say hello, just from a safe distance of 6 feet. And when I want to make sure I'm 6 feet apart from somebody, I picture myself lying on the ground, and then I add a few inches. Now, if I was Michael Jordan, I guess I'd be subtracting. Now, you may be wondering, why is 6 feet the magic number? 6 feet is based on a lot of studies going back many decades about how far infectious droplets can travel through the air after a sneeze or a cough or a shout before they fall to the ground. And you may not think you're sick, but it turns out a person can be infected and not yet know it. What's more, this novel coronavirus is tricky. It turns out COVID-19 is also spread by smaller aerosols that we exhale. And these aerosols can travel more than 6 feet. But in general, 6 feet of distance is a good rule of thumb for this pandemic. That's what experts like Dr. Abrar Karan of Harvard told me, and it's what the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention recommends. And so that brings me back to our first question. How do you tell if you're really 6 feet apart? Now, in some situations, humans are very good at judging distance. Studies have shown if you blindfold someone and tell them to walk a certain number of feet, like 6, they usually do it just fine. But when the blindfold is off and your brain is busy thinking, you may not be as accurate. Social factors can affect the way we judge distance. For example, if you see a snake that's 6 feet away, you might think it's closer than it really is because it could be dangerous and scary. But if your best friend is standing 6 feet away, it might seem like 60 feet, so you might feel the urge to get a little closer. Then there's a phenomenon I like to call line creep. When you're standing in a line, like in a store, you're supposed to be 6 feet apart from other people. But somehow the distance just seems to shrink as everyone edges up. It's human nature. We all want to get to that cashier as soon as possible. So that's when I picture myself lying on the ground. Another good tip to keep that 6 feet of distance is to think about your wingspan. If you reach out one arm and the person you're with reaches out one arm, that's about 6 feet. Then there's the pool noodle method. A restaurant in Germany made special hats for diners with 6-foot-long foam pool toys called noodles attached. You've got 3 feet of noodle in front of you, and so does the next customer. Voila, 6 feet. So what do you do if you're in a situation where someone is getting too close? If it's just a quick pass-by and the person isn't shouting or sneezing into your face, you shouldn't worry too much. The main idea is to avoid prolonged face-to-face contact and crowds, especially indoors, where airflow can't always disperse infectious particles. Another safety precaution, just turn your head away from the other person. Then any droplets or aerosols you're each emitting won't head directly in the other one's direction. And if you do want to say something to someone who's uncomfortably up in your face, there is no perfect phrase, but be polite. You might try, "Hey, you probably don't realize it, but you're a little closer to me than 6 feet. To protect both of us, let's just create a little more space." And if that doesn't work, you might try a gentle nudge with a 6-foot-long pool noodle. I'm Mark Silver from NPR.